it is time to announce our next Cityline Book Club pick. This month, we are reading, drumroll please, Hana Khan Carries On by Uzma Jalaluddin. So this is a sparkling romantic comedy about two competing halal restaurants. It's funny, it's heartwarming, and it is a love story that deals with themes of family and podcasts and racism and supporting local. And what's better than announcing a new book club pick? Well, the author joins us to help introduce it. So welcome to Uzma. Can you tell us a bit more about the book?
Yeah, first of all, thank you so much for choosing Hana Khan Carries On as a Cityline Book Club pick. I'm so honored. So my novel, which ironically I started writing before the pandemic, I started writing this in 2017, as you said, it's basically inspired by the movie You've Got Mail with Tom Hanks and Meg Ryan. Mm-hmm. I'm a romantic comedy buff, and I think that's why I keep writing rom-coms. So my novel is You've Got Mail, except set in rival halal restaurants. And the novel is set in Scarborough, Ontario, so the east end of the city, in a really immigrant-rich neighborhood. And it basically follows, as you said, this little mom-and-pop restaurant, which I named Three Sisters Biryani Poutine. And biryani poutine is a is a signature dish in the book. Doesn't exist in real life. And they're struggling, you know, the neighborhood has changed. And basically what happens is a hipster halal place opens up across the street and really brings a lot of competition into the neighborhood. But the highlight of this book is, as you said, this local community. It's sort of like Gilmore Girls, but with more brown people. That's how I'm describing it.
It is. It's good. And is it wrong that I actually want biryani poutine? Like, I want to try. So food, Uzma, is such a big part of the book and a way the characters show love when words are just not enough. So how does food provide inspiration for your writing?
Food, in this case, was the inspiration for my writing. In fact, I came up with the idea to do a remix of You've Got Mail when I was out for dinner with my husband, as I said, in 2017 for my birthday. And we were in this sort of upscale halal restaurant, and we were just commenting how this place just never existed when we were young. Like, if we wanted halal options, like a halal steak, you had to make it at home. There was no such thing as going to a restaurant and buying it. And so it was really important to me to, like, describe the food, to talk about how food brings cultures together, the way that food provides nuance to communities, and how food tastes really change. Like, my kids are, you know, they're Indian. Technically, their grandparents were born in India, but they are more comfortable eating pizza and pasta and burgers. And I occasionally throw in Indian food, and they're like, okay, fine, we'll have some biryani. Uh-huh. But, you know, it's just everyone's food changes, and it's sort of your food story tells a lot about you.
Yeah, it's a journey, because the only Jamaican food I really liked eating when I was young was a patty and cocoa bread. And then as soon as I went away to school, I needed Jamaican food. It's almost like that was my connection to my mom and my dad. And I looked out and I was buying Jamaican food everywhere I went, and I'd come home for summers, and then it was like, oh, you're eating Jamaican food now. It's like, yeah, it's an interesting part of our journey. So the other thing I found really interesting in your book is it's a romance, but you have not shied away from some tough topics. You know, there's family, there is love, but there's also microaggressions. There is racism, which just, it rankles just to read it, because we've seen it all. We've been through it all. Why did you want to include this in the book?
As a writer who is South Asian, as I said, my parents were immigrated to Canada from India in the 1970s. And as a visible Muslim woman, as someone who wears hijab, this is my reality. And I feel like in a city like Toronto, we kind of sort of try to give ourselves a pass. Like, oh, we're so multicultural, we're so diverse, we don't have those problems here, but we do. And as much as I wanted to write a hopeful, funny, romantic story, I didn't want to shy away from the real issues that someone who is Hannah's age, she's in her early 20s, would be facing as she's sort of on the brink of, like, okay, I've just graduated school, I'm about to enter the rest of my adult life. And she really faces some harsh reality, as you said, from the subtle microaggressions at work all the way to the really obvious hate crime that does take place.
Mm-hmm. I appreciate this book, and I cannot wait to present it to all of our viewers. I'm happy we can do that today. Uzma, thank you for joining us, and congratulations on the book.
Thanks so much, Tracy. I look forward to our chat.
Yes, I can't wait. So Uzma will be joining us again on June 9th at 3 p.m. for a live book club chat or on Cityline's YouTube channel. So that's where you will find us. And I'd love to hear your questions about the book. So join our Cityline Book Club group on Facebook to send in your questions and subscribe to our YouTube channel so that you don't miss it when we go live. We'll let you know. Happy reading, everyone.